So that's the first of our quarterfinals has been completed, and what an excellent match it was. Tantoi Ahmad and Liliana Nasir, the number four seeds, coming through in three thrilling games. Women's singles up next, then men's doubles, then women's doubles and men's singles will finish off quarterfinals day here at the YONEX Denmark Open. Sung Ji-hyun, of course, beaten finalist last year here at the Denmark Open. And Pusala Venkata Sindhu, two-time World Championship bronze medalist. Danes involved in the men's doubles and the men's singles. So the home fans, plenty to look forward to. So three courts in action today on quarterfinals day. Match is already in progress on courts two and three. And our centre courts, number one court at the moment, plunged into darkness. And that's a nice touch. We saw that at the World Championships with the presentation taken to a new level as far as badminton tournaments are concerned, with courts plunged into darkness and the announcements of players coming onto court, highlighting which player is which, and giving the fans a little bit of background about their previous results.
Number one, women's singles. Please welcome from Korea, number four in the world, and winner of the YONEX Taipei Open, Sung Ji-hyun.
So here comes Sung Ji-hyun, the number four seed from Korea.
2014 BWF World Championships. Sindhu.
And her opponents, Pusala Venkata Sindhu, the 19-year-old from Secunderabad in India. Two highly talented youngsters in the world of badminton. So the players are doing battle in the quarterfinal, as you can see from the top half of the draw. And whoever wins the match we're about to witness will play against either the number one seed, the Olympic champion, Li Shui-rei, or Zhang Bei-wen, the winner of the Dutch Grand Prix last week. So a player very much in form. Zhang Bei-wen, of course, now representing the United States of America. So Sung Ji-hyun, number four seed, because she is number four in the world. Beaten finalist last year when she was the number six seed, lost out in the final to the now Asian Games gold medalist Wang Yi-han, and lost in three thrilling games. 14 individual tournaments this year. She won two titles already, the Asian Championships and also the Chinese Taipei Grand Prix gold. Won that, incidentally, for the second consecutive year. And I know, Morton, you were there in Taipei to witness that. She's also been in the final of the German Grand Prix gold. Now, her first round match against Kirsty Gilmore of Scotland, and in the second round against the qualifier, the two-time world junior champion, Akane Yamaguchi. And I thought, Morton, she looked very, very impressive in those first two matches.
I think you're very right, she did. And she won very convincingly against her first two opponents. And especially when she's playing Yamaguchi from Japan, I think that's a very fine result, winning in two straight games.
Well, her opponent, Pusala Venkata Sindhu, number 10 on the world ranking. She has been as high as 9. Not seeded here. She's 16 on the Super Series. Destination Dubai ranking. She's gone up a couple of places after reaching the quarterfinal in the last Super Series prior to this, the Australian event. Now, her first two matches, first of all, against Ip Hui Yin of Hong Kong, came from 16-20 down in the second game to win in two straight. Six straight points to close out that one in the second round against the player promoted from the qualifying event, Polikarpova of Russia. And Polikarpova replaced the world champion,
players ready,
Carolina Marin, the number 8 seed, who actually had to withdraw from the event. So Trish Gubb from New Zealand is our umpire for this one. Jan Ibsen of Denmark, the service judge. Now this is the fourth meeting between these two players. And the previous three have all been won by PV Sindhu. Now, Morton, when we looked at the statistics before the start of this match, we double-checked that, didn't we? We were surprised.
I'm very surprised, and we were surprised, yes. That it must be something to do with playing style.
It must be.
So I'm interested to, I haven't really noticed it like that. And therefore, very surprised indeed. But let's see how it goes.
Sang Ji-hyun, Korea. Sang Ji-hyun to serve. Love all. Play.
So the number 4 seed, Sang Ji-hyun of Korea, the last year's beaten finalist in this quarterfinal match against India's Pusala Venkata Sindhu. Yes, nicely played. Morton, I think I perhaps ought to explain a little bit more about the head-to-heads. The last time they met was a year and 1 week ago in the last 32 of the French Super Series event. So, of course, it was just a couple of days after Sung Ji-hyun had had that marathon final here at the Denmark Super Series, losing out in an hour and 23 minutes to Wang Yihan of China. So that's perhaps a little bit of an explanation. And of course, the second time that they played against each other, sadly Sung Ji-hyun had to retire at 7-2 in the first game. So perhaps the head-to-heads are a little misleading.
On this one, I'm sure, yes. Because I was very, very surprised that it was 3-0 for PV Sindhu.
Service over.
She's off to a good start. She's played two good winners from her smash, and that's where she's got to gain the confidence. Here we had the second one, and she really needs, she's feeding on that confidence she gets from her good attack. And if it's working well, she's playing well.
Just long. Only been played at quite a pace
Three,
there.
Yeah. Two.
It's very, very good pace.
Landed in.
Yep.
The winner, Yung Matthias Fries. Or Magnus Hansen, Sommerbækker,
Oh yes, just inside the back line.
That's a good smash. Nice reply here by Sung. And that, I think she's got to do some more. She's got to add on the pressure on PV Sindhu on that defense, because that is the weakness of the Indian player at the moment. She's a very, very young player. She's still got lots of things to learn. But how well she's done in the World Championships the last two times.
Oh, it's been phenomenal, hasn't it?
Yeah. Get to that semi-final twice is really, really a good result.
Oh, it's just wide. Well,
it is wide.
It is wide, but she's going to challenge. Now, there's something that bothers me there, Morton. She immediately turned to her coach and said, do I challenge?
And then the hand up.
Yeah. Well, I thought the line judge was correct there. But Hawkeye will tell us for sure.
Yes.
Here we go. Oh, just out. My goodness me.
Challenge unsuccessful.
That is 5-3.
One challenge remaining. Service over, 5-3. Play.
Oh, it's wide.
6-3.
Well, of course, Morton, you and I were playing in the days when Sung Ji-hyun's mother was playing.
I used to play her dad.
Yeah.
In men's singles.
Sun Hung Kok.
Yep. He was the best from Korea at the time.
Four, that's right. Six. And mother, Kim Yun-ya, won 4 titles here at the Denmark Open. 1 women's singles and 3 women's doubles.
That's impressive. That's a good record.
We kindly remind you that flash photography is not allowed.
Oh, that's well taken.
5-6.
Yeah, I still think that Sung Ji-hyun is standing a very good chance of winning. You know, Sindhu has played well, but she's only 6-5 up. So if Sung can, you know, minimize the gap between the two when Sindhu is playing her very best, I think she's standing a fair chance. But good cross-court smash here, well left, very well read when she was pushed into that deep forehand corner here. It's coming and then back again there. That's a good shot. That's a very, very good smash.
It's interesting to me, Morton, to compare the Indian player we saw yesterday, Saina Nehwal, who incidentally lost her quarterfinal
earlier today.
And this lady on court right now, PV Sindhu. And I'm not wanting to compare the styles of play, I'm wanting to compare the body language that we've seen throughout this week, and I think it's totally different. Of course, that second bronze medal in the World Championships for PV Sindhu has done wonders.
Yep.
But look at the way already in this opening game she's really fired up, and maybe totally different personalities. I don't know them well enough, but it's amazing difference, isn't it?
It is.
Look at determination there before the serve.
Service over. 6-10.
I think in the last year or so since we've been watching PV Sindhu from one world championship to the next, you know, I think she has noticeably improved her physical strength, and which is not surprising. I mean, she's turned into a 19-year-old, and you know, when you're 17, 18, of course you're still very much a girl. And I think now that physically she's turned into a better specimen, is making a huge impact on her game.
Yeah, we discussed it on many occasions that she still has to improve the strength in her legs and her ability to change direction and all that. But I totally concur with you. She is much, much better now. The last six months, I think she has improved a lot.
Yeah.
And I think she did really well in the Uber Cup, playing the second singles for her nation back in May. And she had some really, really hard fights, but won a lot of them.
She won all of them.
All of them.
All of them. Played five times as second women's singles, won five times.
Yeah. It's impressive. She did well. And some of them, she was way out and had to crawl back, and she did it.
Yeah.
And that gives the mental stamina as well.
Absolutely, strategy, bilkul theek hai. Aise khelna, niche niche niche. But be ready, you have to keep the pressure on and that cheer up, aise hi, josh mein khelna. Theek hai? That's it, keep it up.
Well, we're just hearing the voice of Madhu Mitlabish and her advice during that interval, and she said you have to be ready, you've got to get those legs ready to push off and move quickly. And I think she's moving very well at the moment.
Yeah, she's doing well.
Service over. 7-12.
Yeah, either Sung Ji-hyun have to start attack like what we saw here, or maybe the edge, the top of Sindhu's game will fall because she can't maintain the same pace and power and speed and all that. So she will be dropping. And maybe that's what she's waiting for. So, you know, we will have to see.
Mm. But you see, I'm with you. I like that sort of shot we just saw there from Sung Ji-hyun, that where she takes the initiative and she creates a wonderful angle.
Yeah.
And I think too often she perhaps just reacts to what her opponent is doing rather than force the issue and dictate the pace of the rally.
Exactly. Take the initiative, as she did here as well, adding on some pressure. In some of the rallies, you don't have to do it all the time, but you have to go in and win your own points now and again. You cannot just rely on mistakes from your opponent.
Park Tae-sang, Korean coach there.
Service over, 13-9.
This is a good comeback by Sung Ji-hyun, I think. She's really, as what we just described before, she's taking much more initiative now. She's much more on the ball and really want to play some winners as well. not just only reacting to whatever her opponent is doing to her.
Yeah, in fact, she's back level.
13.
Four-point deficit has been closed. It was a one-time five-point deficit at the mid-game interval. Oh, it's been well, well wide. And for the first time, since leading 2-1, back into the lead.
I think what we're seeing here is still a very raw talent in Sindhu. She was very successful in the early stages of the match, attacking like what she did here, but very successful. Suddenly, she was trailing 14-13, and she's lost four or five in a row, but she still kept on playing the same and the same and the same. She's got to make some changes. She's got to, okay, I'm not winning on that one anymore. I have to save it a little bit. I have to play another shot. I have to play more variation and all that. She's just steamrolling. She's playing the same shot every single time, and she's got to watch out because players are getting used to it, they settle down, okay, this is what's coming, this is what's coming, and then eventually they start to counter-attack it.
Oh, well, that's very, very good placement of the smash there from PV Sindhu, aimed towards the right hip. In fact, hit the right hip.
Play. Spot on.
Taking their time, they can sense this is a big, big point.
Yeah, but the umpire have to be aware. So next time Sung Ji-hyun is getting caught in that deep forehand corner, not on that smash, but when she's pushed into that deep forehand corner, she's always playing a straight drive down the line. Sindhu is already standing there waiting for it. I'm telling you, a drop shot cross would just be a straight winner.
Placement.
Please welcome from China, world number 25 and winner of this year's China Masters Grand Prix gold, Lu Xin.
Well, it really is cat and mouse in this opening game, isn't it? The ebb and flow of the game.
Also from China.
As one player gets the advantage, three, and the other catches back up.
Both this year's Korea and Singapore Open. Ji-hyun! The umpire is Jürgen Gingery. And the service judge is Jens Kuster.
Nice. Yeah, the 23-year-old from Seoul is now beginning to really find her range. A number of times more than that, I watch her play, Sung Ji-hyun, and I think she's a slow starter. She always looks as if she's slightly stiff in her movement. I'm quite certain she does warm up properly, but
yeah, I'm sure she does.
But you know what I mean?
Yeah, she's got to settle in.
Yeah.
And I think you're right, she is a slow starter. We've seen it on a number of occasions now. Yeah. She's one of the players on the world circuit, and as I see it, Sung Ji-hyun, is that she can do better than what she's doing.
Yeah.
I think her talent can take her further. And she's got to step up some pace and physical training and all that and be able to push harder, add on some more pressure, because she can do it. And she can really win a lot of tournaments if she just up the pace just 5-10%. And she can do it.
Yeah. Well, she's just 2 points away from this opening game. Towards her coach. Should I have left that? Would have gone long.
if.
Yes.
We will never know.
Super angle.
Game point 19.
That's a good angle because his play from that one there first, that drive, that attacking clear down to the deep forehand corner, and then she's moving into the center of the court, Sindhu, and then it's same side but just a short one.
Yeah.
And she's got to change angle the whole time to get it, and that's why the shot was so clever. That was why it was so effective.
Game point opportunity. And that is well saved. Oh, my goodness me, what an opening game.
Yeah, one of the most difficult shots in the book. A straight drop shot. From a very difficult angle here, very difficult. That is, that's a good shot.
Yeah, lovely racket head control from PV Sindhu. And at 20 all, it means we need extra points until there's a clear 2 point winning margin.
20 all. Play.
One more time.
Yeah, same shot, same result. Yeah, right, winner. Oh, having just saved a game point, now PV Sindhu, a game point herself.
That's a good pace. Really good pace. That's the one. That's the one. It came at the crucial time. That's the one I've been waiting for the whole game. And then she played it. Isn't that good?
Umpire Trish Gubb from New Zealand is good.
Must be continuous. It's taking way too long.
Quite right too.
Mm-hmm. We mentioned it earlier.
Yep.
And then they still take their time.
Yes. 21 all. So now a second game point opportunity to the number four seed from Korea. Oh, my goodness, no. Well, perhaps at this stage I should mention I said that we needed a clear two-point winning margin. If we get to 29 all, it will be sudden death.
Yes, but that won't happen. No, it won't.
Famous last words, yeah. Morten Frost.
It won't happen.
Service over, 23-22.
Third game point opportunity for Sun Ji-hyun.
Who dares wins.
Oh, it's wide.
Oh, she almost touched it.
She did, didn't she?
She was very, very close.
23 all.
Out. Pushed it out.
But good courage to try and play the net shot off the net shot.
Yep.
I like the idea, but as you say, just wide. And therefore, a fourth game point opportunity for the number four seed. And this time she converts.
It won't happen.
25-23, the scoreline. And the number four seed, Sung Ji-hyun, having to come back from a five-point deficit at that mid-game interval. What a good opening game.
Yeah, very, very good quality we've seen here. Wonderful to watch.
Then variations, mid-court mile ka tab mar, but niche niche, theek hai na? And sometimes when you get it, na, instead of going sideline, body pe maro, first ja rahi hai. Theek hai? You have to make her move. And especially from the forehand, when you're like this, na, don't play cross toss, flat, no. So, tum wo straight ye ka, theek hai? And net pe jahan mile, usko push karke na, rakh, ya, cross guma. Everything is all right, little bit. And keep patience, mile, tab maar. You know, aise look lamba bhi jayega na, zup, zup maarege to wo phas rahi hai, peeche jaake wahan pe mushkil. Especially cross, there, there, diagonal. Fir wahan se, fir push kar. Kar rahe, man, get opening. You're moving well, playing well, that's it, keep it up.
Yeah, you're moving well.
Same way.
You're playing well.
Khali uska kya hai, wahan se, wahan pe. वो एक मार रही है इवन स्मैश भी कई बार ये अच्छा फोरहैंड टू फोरहैंड कॉर्नर मार रही है लेग्स रेडी रहेगी ना बिल्कुल यू आर देयर वो अनएक्सपेक्टेड कई बार क्रॉस मार रहा है ठीक है एंड समटाइम्स व्हेन यू आर पुशिंग हर देयर ना लाइक सो ड्रिबल नहीं कर सकती ऐसे घुमा वेरिएशंस के लिए वहां पुश कर या घुमा नेट पे यू स्ट्रेट अप कम ऑन दैट्स इट यू कैन डू इट कम ऑन
들어와가지고 뒤로 누잖아? 지혜네가 이렇게 잡잖아 이렇게 잡으면은 신두 몸이 선생님 어제 얘기했지 신두가 딱 이렇게 딱 이러고 있단 말이야 거기서 지연이가 뒤로 갖다 주면 바로 대각선 맞는 거야 그리고 지연이한테 지연이한테 걔가 딱 때려놓고 지연이 카트 했지 4번으로 빨리 밀었단 말이야 지연이 딱 잡는 순간 준비 동작이 뒤로 갔단 말이야 그러니까 4번에서 그렇게 많이 당한 거야 그럴 때 차라리 직선으로 클리어를 쳐 직선으로 4번보다는 세컨캐드도 명심해야 돼 그러니까 똑같은 거 또 주면 안 돼 지연이가 주고 빨리 카트 했으면 돼 나 너무 날카롭게
27 minutes for that enthralling opening game. 25-23, number 4 seed from Korea coming through in the end against PV Sindhu. Well defended.
Yeah, good defense. Just going wide. We will never know now. Well, Sindhu is really playing at good pace. She is pushing it hard.
Morten, I want to just pick up on something you said in that opening game about Sung Ji-hyun and, you know, her talent and her ability is quite obvious. We can both see that. And your comment that she needed to improve her pace by about 10%, 5 or 10%,
yeah.
So that she's quicker, so she can really start challenging on a regular basis,
yes.
These top players. It occurs to me she's played 21 tournaments
she's playing
over
a lot.
The last 12 months.
She's one of those players playing the most on the circuit.
Yes. And I'm wondering if, in fact, you know, it's almost like, I know when any badminton player trains, of course, if you do too much distance running for your stamina, then you start to plod a little bit on court, don't you? You need to combine the stamina with the explosive work. And if you go from one tournament to the next and to the next tournament and to the next, it's almost as if you get into that plodding mode.
Yeah.
Do you understand what I mean?
Yes.
And I'm wondering if I can see for the development, and I have been a huge advocate over the last few years. The international players have been saying, we play too much, we've got to take rests. And I'm saying tennis players have to play at least 19 tournaments a year on the ATP tour. And a lot of them play a lot more than
this.
You know, and I look at the badminton players and quite frankly, you know, some of them are playing under 10 as far as ranking. They could cope with more. You should be able to play more than once a month. So I don't want to sort of go against my own principle in that players should be able to play more regularly. But I'm looking at her and I'm seeing somebody that's almost on the treadmill of one tournament to the next, to the next, to the next, to the next, and she perhaps needs some time out to work on that speed.
Yes. I fully agree. I have no words. It's you know, it's the pros and cons of everything, and I think you covered it so well that, you know, we want players to play more. Yes, they can play more than 10 tournaments a year. 21 is possibly a little bit too high, and we should encourage players to play more, and this is a challenge, and it is out.
Challenge unsuccessful. No challenges remaining.
Well, that's her two challenges gone. Sun Ji-hyun.
But you need time in the training hall as well.
Because, you know, I've had in my mind that for the last 3 years I've been saying Sun Ji-hyun, but she's so young. You know, she's got plenty of time to develop, and playing the tournaments, getting the experience will help that develop. She's 23 now.
It's time.
It's time. It's time to stop showing potential,
yeah,
and it's time to start producing results.
Yes.
Please welcome the technical officials of
court
number 2.
Oh, that's a nice one.
Beautiful. And she's got no challenges left.
No.
So she can't challenge that. I thought it was good anyway.
Yeah, it is good. She's got to live with it.
Now it's perfect length on that cross court clear. That's lovely.
Please welcome from Korea, world number 1, winners of this year's Indonesia Open, and the runners up at the 2014 BWF World Championships, Lee Yong Dae and Yoo Yong Soo. They're facing from Indonesia, number 9 of the world, and winner of the 2014 YONEX Sunrise Indonesian Masters,
That's good judgment. Just long.
6-4.
Now, when we were watching yesterday, Morten, Danish coach, talked in the women's doubles about the drift in the arena, and I've been watching very, very carefully. I know that one went a bit long, but I'm still not convinced there's hardly any drift at all.
It's very close to perfect playing conditions.
Yeah. Certainly the players have been talking to me, all very happy with the playing conditions.
It's a very intimate place to play as well. Mm. You know, spectators are really close, and they can feel the pace, they can feel the heartbeat of the players because it's so close, and that's what makes it a little bit unique.
Yeah.
So the tournament has been held here in Odense for, what, 7 years? 8 years? Is this the...
This is the 8th consecutive year in Odense.
So they will... after this one, I think there will be a renegotiation of contract for another 4 years. So interesting to see whether Odense will remain the venue for the Denmark Open.
Well, it's certainly one of the... oldest and most prestigious tournaments in world badminton, isn't it? This is, I've worked out, the 64th Denmark Open.
Yeah, some mid-30s since the
1935.
Yeah. But the All England was played first time, what, 1898?
Yeah, they've certainly had their centenary.
Yep.
Oh, just wide, my goodness me.
Service over.
Like that net shot.
Nine, five.
I remember in Lucknow at the beginning of the year, Morten, you and I at the Syed Modi Grand Prix Gold event, and you and I sat and talked about this young lady, PV Sindhu, and how she needed to play more at the net and improve her net play. She's done that already. We're only 10 months into the year.
Yep.
And there's a noticeable improvement.
Absolutely. She lost the match against Sina Neville, not purely because of net play, but it was playing a big part in the match of that final of that tournament.
Yeah.
And she simply couldn't match her opponent on it.
But look at that. Look at the way she lunged forward.
She's getting it a lot higher and a lot earlier.
Yeah. Both forehand and backhand.
Yes.
Seven of the last 8 points to PV Sindhu.
Service over, 6-10.
That Sung Ji-hyun can get before the mid-game interval is very important to her for this second game.
Service over, 11-7, interval.
Well, it is a 4-point difference between the two players. And the advantage is with the number 4 seed. You probably played against him as well, didn't you? Or was he slightly after your time?
I think he was after my time.
But Tai-sang?
Yeah, he was after my time.
He's a left-hander, wasn't he, if I remember correctly?
I'm not entirely sure, I must admit. We have to look it up because I think he's right-handed.
You would remember the men's singles better, players better than I would. I'll bow to your superior knowledge.
Thanks, but don't do it. It's all a hoax.
Not at all. Well, two Indian coaches now, because the men's singles quarterfinals, Shrikant Kabat Dambi.
He lost.
He lost to Korean opponent, Seung-Hwan Ho.
He was 20-15 up in the first, and he lost 23-21.
Crikey.
And we've seen that once before. He did that in the final in Lucknow, when he was up against a young Chinese player. And he was way up, having won the first game, and then he lost it, and then lost the third. something he's got to work on.
Done it.
Yeah.
9-11.
One of the absolute favourite shots, that cross court slice shot from PV Sindhu. So the umpire really have to push the pace of the match now. By Sindhu, really got it up, got very early on that drop shot and forced the area from Sung Ji-hyun. But the two girls here, they're really, really taking their time between rallies now, and I think a warning is very appropriate at the moment.
The lift was short and it got what it deserved.
Yeah, but it was a good chance to take. Did that pass, it would have been a good shot. But well covered by the Korean.
Surprised by where the shuttle actually landed, Morton. I wonder whether there really is a drift when I see that one.
Yeah, it looked a little bit sideways from where we're sitting. And she just managed to create a spin to it.
The sort of shot where it says to me she's lost her discipline here, her mental discipline. She's got a little bit frustrated that she's been playing so well, and as you pointed out, that hasn't converted to her advantage, and so many of what she believes perhaps should be
winners
are coming back, that she just goes for a little too much.
It's becoming frustration.
Yeah.
And I think she should listen to her coach, because one of the things she said, amongst many, that you've got to be patient. That's a good run of points for the Koreans. Must be something like 6 or 7 out of the last 7 or 8 points.
Yes, indeed. She was 5-10 down, wasn't she?
Yeah. So that's what I mean. The game is really slowing down between rallies now, and if the umpire before felt that she wanted continuous play, she really have to enforce it now.
Mm.
Let's go,
as in. That's way in. Yeah. Oh, that's nice.
Mm.
That's a very nice change of shot here by Sindhu.
Yeah, technically good too. Very yes. little backswing of the racket there.
That's really nice. Good change. Very nice variation here.
14 all.
Unlucky for Sindhu.
Mm.
She read it well. She played the right shot, I thought. And it stayed on top of the tape there. Fell down to her own side. And I think that was desperately unlucky. I think that was a very good chance and a good opportunity for her to win the point.
Well, 11 of the last 15 points to the Korean. Emphasises your point, doesn't it?
Oh, good return nice. Of serve.
Yep.
Positive. Get up there. Get early. One of the things I always emphasise to the players I'm coaching, got to be aggressive on the return of serve.
That's interesting because I don't think enough singles players really have that mentality.
I'm not saying that you should try to score a winner, but you
no.
reach it early, play it with pressure. You have to do that.
Yeah.
You have to be difficult to serve to.
Mm.
Tired now, I'm telling you, look at that, that hurts.
Yeah. Yep.
She's not getting to that one yet, look at that. She is getting so tired now.
Well, she's down, but not quite out, lying on the floor. Get up, please. Well, the umpire's saying get up, please. Goodness me, that was an important point, wasn't it? Look at her. No, it's not time for bed yet.
It is time for mopping up.
Mm. We should have had a stopwatch on from the moment that rally ended.
We should have.
Players on court, please.
Yeah, good umpiring. See, the thing is that I know people watching this possibly say to us, Morten, we're being a little harsh because we've had a magnificent women's singles, played at a terrific pace,
absolutely.
The rallies. Both players are trying to take the rest. So if both players are getting the same advantage, then what's the problem? What's the issue? Well, the issue to me is that the physicality of our sport should be an important aspect of our sport, and therefore it should be tested.
Yes. And because the two players agree it should not be tested, that's not the case.
No, exactly. Yeah. Exactly.
I think Sindhu is standing a good chance at the moment. I think she is the strongest at the moment. That hurts. That hurts.
Oh.
She wanted a winner there.
Oh.
She desperately wanted a winner there, the Korean. I think she is in trouble.
You could see the batteries just slowing her down, couldn't you? Yeah.
Change.
53 minutes this quarter final has been in progress, and we're not even into a decider.
I think the Korean is going all out trying to close it in two.
Yeah, I think she has to.
Yeah.
Well, I have my doubts whether she'll be able to.
The Sindhu looks by far the strongest at the moment.
Mm. It's gone long.
19-16.
Five straight points for PV Sindhu. That's a good smash.
Service over.
19. We are having some fun here.
Yeah.
This is tight.
Who's got the nerve?
Both of them wants to play the shots. Try to finish the rallies as quickly as possible. Good smash down the line there. She's going all out.
Oh.
Whoa!
Missed opportunity, and she knows it. My goodness me. Well, I don't think I'm being unkind to say that's possibly the worst shot she's played all match.
And maybe one of the most important ones.
Yeah. All level once more in this second game. 19 all.
Thank you.
Well, there's a little spring in the step there of PV Sindhu. She must be hurting too.
Yeah, but not as much as her opponent.
Yeah. And look at the reaction of Sung Ji-hyun after that as well, the disappointment. So now it's a game point opportunity for PV Sindhu to level this quarter final at one game apiece. Oh, goodness me.
Come here.
Yep, Sorry. Umpire's going to have a word with that.
If that happens again, I will award her the point. Be ready to play.
Well, that's quite clear. If it happens again, I will award your opponent the point.
Yeah.
And quite right, too.
That's out.
Wide. Oh, my goodness, she took it.
Let's go to 29 now.
It will never happen.
It will never.
I want to quote somebody. It will never happen.
I think it's wonderful. It's really a very good match to watch.
Yes.
And I hope all of you watching it at home, wherever you are, you are having the same fun as we have. This is very good quality.
Well, PV Sindhu missing the opportunity there. And having saved the game point, now Sung Ji-hyun has a match point opportunity. She's done it, coming from behind in the second game, 5-10 down at one stage, and she battled and battled and battled, held her nerve in the end. The number four seed, Sung Ji-hyun. Umpire confirming the score, 25-23, 22-20, in exactly an hour of play for two games
only.
That is extraordinary. What a match. I thought she was out for the count at one stage, but it was sheer determination. Battling through, sheer willpower. And she's safely through to the semi-final. 25-23, 22-20. And Sung Ji-hyun, last year's beaten finalist, through to the semi-final.
Thanks, I like the word safely.
Well, just two of our quarterfinals completed. We're almost, is that right? Two and a half hours in? My goodness me. Men's doubles coming up next, and it features, of course, the Olympic silver medalists Matthias Boll and Carsten Mogensen. And then we have women's doubles. That could be a long, hard battle as well. And we end with a men's singles.